and Brad, the two most famous physical therapists on the internet.
Hi folks, I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Heineck, physical therapist.
Together we are the most famous physical therapists on the internet.
In our opinion, of course,
Brad, science says that these exercises can relieve your back pain, especially if it's chronic. And these are stretches and strengthening. So we're quoting a study here.
Yeah, but what does Brad and Bob say?
Brad and Bob agree.
Okay.
So this study was called a randomized trial comparing yoga, stretching, and a self-care booklet for chronic back pain. So let me break this down. There's 228 adults.
Okay.
And of that amount, they had 92 do yoga once a week.
Okay.
On a 75 minute program or something like
right.
that. Another 91 or 92 people did that. 91 people just did a stretching and strengthening program by physical therapists.
Okay.
And a 45, this is the control group, they basically were given a book for self-care.
Okay. So just an educational.
Right. And what they found at the end, by the way, we got a phone going off here.
Okay. You want me to go throw it on the ground?
No. All right. What they found is that these two groups ended up doing well. Their back pain both went down.
Okay.
So we're advocating yoga or stretching. Because we're not experts on yoga, we're going to go ahead and show you the stretching program.
Right. And yoga people, you can comment in if we,
yeah.
you know.
Yoga's great too. So, by the way, if you are new to our channel, please
right.
take a second to subscribe to us. We provide videos on how to stay healthy, fit, pain-free, and we upload every day. And also make sure to like us on Facebook because we like to be liked. All right, we're gonna start right at about the 2 minute mark here, Brad. And this program should take maybe about 10 minutes if we do 30 minutes or 30 second stretches. Once you lay down.
Assume the position.
We're almost at 2 minutes here. That way people will know when they come back. Start around at the 2 minute mark. Here we go. We're gonna start doing trunk rotations, Brad.
Oh yeah.
So he's rotating back and forth. If it hurts in one direction, don't go that direction. Just go in the direction you like. If it hurts for going too far, just start with rotations that are not as far. Just go into this range right in here and then eventually work further and further. So this is a good universal one. Most people can do this one. We often recommend this one right after you've hurt your back even because you're in bed. All right, next one, Brad. We've
yes.
got 30 seconds. Bridging.
Bridging.
So with this one now you're getting a little bit of strengthening. Again, it's generally not too hard for people. Don't you find this one, Brad? Most
right.
people can do this one. So you get a little bit of core strengthening. You're getting some movement in the back. You can, again, start off, if 30 seconds is too long for you, maybe start off with 20
right.
or 10. Or do a lower amount, but it's a good, again, universal one. This next one, Brad, is a little harder to teach, isn't it? Pelvic tilts.
Oh, the famous pelvic tilt. So you can see the line here from the green to the black, and maybe that I can.
Yeah, that helps. So what he's doing basically is you're gonna have your legs up like this, and if I put my hands on a hand underneath here, he's squishing my hand. All right, so you're using you're tilting the pelvis down like that.
And that's providing a lot of range of motion in that low back.
Yep. It's a good thing to learn where your pelvis is at so that when you have to do lifting or anything like that, you can go ahead and do that. All right, single knee to chest, Brad.
Oh, yes.
So you're going to first do one, and you're going to bring it up, and you're going to squeeze like that. If you have trouble, you can grab underneath the leg, too.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying, Brad?
Yep, right yep. there.
If you have a great amount of trouble, you could actually use a strap.
Right.
We have the yoga strap here. Again, anytime we mention a product, we put it down below in our product description. So,
yeah, and for a lot of people, you may, if you're younger, very
all right,
athletic,
Brad,
this is easy. But
going to double knee to chest.
Oh,
now.
Double knee, and we might yeah. need it for that as well. That's
yeah.
even, particularly if your back hurts.
Yeah.
This might be painful, but this.
Yeah. And make sure none of these should hurt. If this hurts, I don't want you doing it. Don't include this one in your repertoire.
Mm-hmm.
But this one, especially if you have a disc problem, this is one you wouldn't want to do.
Right.
I mean, this is going to make it worse. But if you don't, it should be fine. All right, Brad, why don't you go into a hamstring stretch? Now, again, the strap would work out well for that. If you don't have a strap, you might have to use a long sheet and pull it up or a belt.
You can go like this.
And you can go like this, yep. That's another alternative. And you're still getting a pretty good stretch on the hamstring. Good alternative to do it. All right then, Brad, we're moving, we're a little bit early, okay. Now you got them both in. Let's go to like an IT band where you cross your leg over and then lift up the other one. Yep, that's one way to do it, yep.
Boy, this really feels good, Bob.
Yep, I actually do this one now. I wasn't doing this one, but so, and obviously you're gonna wanna do it on both sides, but he's gonna kick out the cabinets here probably to do it.
Oh, good, so there's glass up there, Bob.
Good IT band stretch. Again, that also can affect the back. All right, then we're gonna do heel cord, Brad.
Heel cord, laying down?
Yeah, you can if you want it. You can sit up while you're doing it, like that.
This is where this strap really comes in handy, where if you're gonna stretch a heel cord here.
Yeah, if you're gonna do a daily stretch routine, I guess I would think about getting a strap or something like that. It's just, it's well worth it.
They're not real expensive.
They're not expensive, right. And they're fitting to most people's budgets.
And you can do this one standing too, but this is the option for supine.
All right, Brad, I'm gonna have you get up and I'm gonna go ahead and do some, those were all laying down. Now the next one is prone, and this is kind of the standard one that we love everybody to do. Put your hands underneath your shoulders and you're gonna press up like this. If it's painful, go up only as high as it'll allow you. We don't want you lifting up your pelvis here. You're gonna be stretching like this and you're doing repetitions here. This is a great one to do. I do it every day.
Bob did say something he didn't mean to say. He said everyone to do, but it's not everyone, it's just most people. If you got spinal stenosis or spondylolisthesis, those people will not want to do this.
You're not going to want to do it, exactly. Then I'm going to go right into alternating arms and legs, Brad. And this one works out well if you have a pillow underneath you. You want to throw me a pillow real quick? You hum that one in there. So, okay, what I'm doing here is I'm going to lift my arm, opposite arm and opposite leg. And now we're getting some strengthening going on here.
Yeah,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Nice. How are we doing for time?
Okay, next one. We're actually doing a hip flexor stretch, and this is where I would need the strap. Do you mind giving me the strap?
I'll give you the strap.
You can actually. You can actually also just grab like this and do it on your side and like this.
Sure.
This actually works out just as well, too.
Why don't you roll over so they can see what's going on back there, Bob?
I'm going to roll over.
Is your mic on that side? Oh, I see.
And so I'm stretching like this.
Yep.
Good one to do because the hip flexor often does get tight where you're sitting, and then it will pull on your back while you're doing it. All right, I think we're up to you, Brad. Now we're in the, I'll keep going. Quadruped position.
Go on, Bob, take it away.
So now we're doing cat camel, Brad.
Oh yeah, these are nice.
So this is really good for the mid back. Actually works the low back a little bit too.
And we have to apologize, the name of this, some people call it something different, but we call it the cat and the camel and we're sticking to it.
All right, next one, Brad. This is kind of advanced one of the one that we were just doing laying down. Yeah. You might have trouble doing this one to start off with. But what I usually do is I do repeats like this.
Yep.
And I actually go up like this and then to the side and then to the back and I'm moving the leg. So I'm going like this.
Good for the shoulder posture.
Yeah, good for getting the retractors there, isn't it? So where are we at? Okay, next one. I want you to put your legs kind of far apart like this, knees far apart, and you're gonna stretch forward like this. And this kind of gets the low back, but also the mid back too, if you're doing it right.
So you don't have to bring your butt down to your heels?
You can do it that way too. You can go all the way down, however you want to stretch. I don't like do it that way. I like to get more in the mid back. But yeah, if you want to get the low back, then you would go more that direction there. I think we're ready for the seated one, Brad.
Okay.
Hallelujah stretch.
Hallelujah. This is a nice chair for this because it hits me in the right area. If it's too tall of a back and it hits you up by the top of the shoulders, it's too tall. But here we can go like this and stretch back. You can bring your hands back like this. Depends on your shoulders. If you got painful shoulders, you may not tolerate this. So you can do it here as well. Oh, and I'm going to go down a notch. It feels good if I adjust where that makes contact with my back.
All right, if you want to face them now, Brad, do a kind of a quadratus lumborum stretch.
Oh, the old QL, quadratus lumborum.
So
I'm going to stabilize my pelvis.
Yep.
And I'm going to go this way and a little bit forward. And, you know, one thing we didn't mention with all these, Bob, is make sure you're breathing and you're breathing
relaxed. Oh, yeah, good point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very important. Really makes a big difference on how you stretch. Much better stretch quality with good relaxed breathing.
Okay. If we want to get just a couple more here, Brad, we could do. You could do a. I just always think this is a good functional exercise. You're strengthening the legs and the back a little bit.
Sure.
Just doing some squats.
Yep.
And the reason that those are good is that's you want to teach yourself that's how you're going to lift.
Sure.
You're going to teach yourself that you're lifting by bending down like this instead of bending like this.
Right.
So by doing lots of these, you're strengthening the legs, getting yourself prepared for it, and now you're going to lift correctly.
Yeah. And I like this. If you just put a
That's a good cue, Brad.
Yep.
That actually is.
Just take a stick behind your back, broomstick, or what do you have? This is a PVC pipe, and it forces you to have good shoulder posture, which really straightens.
That's really a great idea, actually, and that's hard to believe it came from you.
Well, so, Bob, I'll give you more than
all
you
right.
deserve.
Well, then let's also show the other functional thing is often you want to lift like this, right, Brad? You
sure.
want to go down and grab things like this.
Yep, keeping that back straight.
So you can do lunges the same way. You're going to go ahead and put your bar up here to keep good posture, and you're going to do a lunge.
Yep.
And now with a lunge, remember, the thing we always want to remember is not have the knee go past the front of the foot if you can.
Yep.
So you don't want it to go like that. You want to keep it back, so you're just kind of dipping down like that.
Right. There's a lot of little tricks. You do not need to have fancy equipment to do good exercises.
Right. So that's the program. We're talking about a lot of dedication here, Brad.
Right.
But you do something like this, and it's not going to only get you in better shape, but it's going to get your back in better shape, and your pain levels are going to go down.
Right. So do it properly. And again, Bob, this is one of those things. Science is really working good with the back, but once again,
we can fix just about anything
except for
a broken heart.
Right. And when we get a science review on that, then we're really going to have some attention.
Sounds good. Thanks, Brad.